What's up, folks? It's your favorite sorcerer. Already so packed with a new video in which I want to talk about how to get the energy for your spells. Now, first of all, why it is important to have a lot of energy for your spells and where do you get that energy from? So the way magic works is the following way. There's a world of physical objects, 3D, where we usually want to have the effect of our spells. Okay? This is where we want to see the results. Where the manipulation happens is in a more subtle realm, in a world of energy, the world of ideas, right? And the more energy you can put into a visualization or a goal or whatever that is, the more likely and the faster it's going to manifest for you. So energy is really a critical point in this equation. I'm sure you can see that. So how do you get more of this energy? Because if you're not getting results with your spells, there's only, you know, a couple of reasons. And one of those is that you don't have enough energy, that you don't put enough energy into the spell. Good. So for that, we need to look at the structure of you. All right. So we have your physical body. We have your energy body and we have you. Okay. The real you is not your body, it's not your mind, it's not your emotions, it's not your energy. It is an individual point of consciousness, you could say, that experiences through these things. When you visualize a cat, create a cat in your imagination, who's looking at that? That's you. You are looking at the cat, but you're not that image. Okay? So this maybe shows you that you're not your mind. So the mind, the energy that can be commanded through the mind and your body are supposed to be used in the right way. There's a whole lot of subtle energy around us, okay? The prana, the chi, whatever you want to call it, it's unlimited energy. But we need to bring it into ourselves and we need to direct it. And this is what we do in a spell. We bring it into ourselves from the environment, from the more subtle dimensions that are all around us and permeate all of the physical universe. We bring that into ourselves and then we direct it towards our goal. It's like we create a blueprint through our imagination and then we put all of this energy into that. It's like a little explosion that we cause or a condensation, and that condensation that leads to a physical manifestation. This is the essence of, you know, the manifestation of a spirit. This is the essence of a candle spell. This is the essence of any type of magic that you would want to do, right? So how do you increase the amount of that energy? So that requires a certain way of understanding that I'm about to give you, and also a certain way of a regular daily practice of some things, okay? Most people nowadays in the occult will have you believe that the physical body is not important when it comes to these things. No, the physical body is extremely important when it comes to magic, all right? The subtle tissues, the fascia, all of this stuff is able to generate and, you know, to bring in chi, subtle energy, and to direct it. But for that, you have to train it in the right way. The body has to be trained in the right way. It needs to be flexible. The inner structure has to be built up, okay? The inner structure is not what you can build up in a gym. Just by lifting weights and all this bullshit, you're not gonna be able, I can't stop cussing. Just through lifting weights and building up external muscles, which is a good thing, don't get me wrong. Building muscles is good, but you have to balance it out with internal flexibility and building up the inner structure, the fascia, the subtle body, you know. And that is then going to be able to bring in more of the subtle energy, okay? So the physical body needs to be trained in a certain way. Number two, we could call this emotional training. Physical training next to it, emotional training. Emotional training is usually connected to breath work. Okay, breath work and getting the subtle energies to move. There are many, many various techniques for that. The most accessible to you is probably going to be some sort of a yoga practice. But what that does is, it, when I say emotional training, what that does is it teaches you how to build up this emotional, and emotions are nothing but energy in motion, this emotional body, to harmonize it, to redirect its movements, and basically gain control over it. It makes you very, very good at harnessing the subtle energy all around us. And it also teaches you how to change the course of those emotions. Very, very important. Because if you want to generate a certain result, you need to be able to match the frequency of that, which, you know, manifests itself, among other things, in different emotional states. And when you can jump from one to another, to another, to another, intentionally, then you have attained a certain level of adapthood when it comes to that. Okay? And the last part is mental training. The mind needs to be trained as well. In this case, we're probably talking about concentration exercises. Why concentration? Because concentration is important to direct the energy. You know, you create the structure of the body in the right way so it can house more of that energy, you can bring it in. Then you have the breath work, which teaches you how to build up the emotional body, which is essentially the container of all of this energy that you accumulated. And the concentration will then allow you to direct it towards whatever it is that you want. This is massive power that very, very few people even start to build up. But if there's anything, the most basic thing that I could recommend to you when it comes to building up magical power is those three things: the body, the emotions, and the mind, the concentration. Okay. Concentration will allow you to use your mind like a laser, and zip, it will cut through steel, if you know what I mean. Very important things. Now, there's a certain way to feed your body as well. You know, you don't have to go raw or anything. You don't have to stop eating meat or anything, but just make sure that it is, you know, high quality food, not too much. Keep your weight in check. Keep the ratio between muscles and fat decent. Keep it good. What does that mean? You don't have to be too muscular. Too muscular is also, you don't have to be 2% body fat. What I'm trying to say is essentially, it has to be a healthy ratio. Look up whatever that is. Build up the internal structure of the body. Do Qigong or pranayama. Learn to build up this emotional body. Do emotional training. Expose yourself to stressful situations and focus on maintaining a specific energy, regardless of what's going on around you. Your inner world needs to be stronger than what you're experiencing externally. Now that leads into building a specific character, right? The character is what you are in the invisible worlds, which determines a lot when it comes to your magical success, right? We're going to go into that in probably some other videos, but please understand that your emotional state and your ability to control your emotional states, regardless of what's going on around you, is the equivalent to being in control and being greater than that, right? I'm going to leave it at that. Hopefully you get something out of this. And of course, I'm going to put out more videos that explain these things in more detail. For now, I just was inspired to do this video because when you work with very, very advanced things, when you build your own magical system, when you are constantly involved in, you know, things that are, you know, reserved for adepts, you tend to forget that a lot of people don't know the basics, which I was reminded of recently through a conversation. So the very basics are what everything is based on. When you have the basics down, when you practice them, you can build a big house on top of the foundation. If not, nothing is going to work. Okay, so don't waste your time. Build the foundation. And a lot of the understandings that you need come from this very practice. Please understand this. There will be things that come to you, that will be given to you in terms of understanding just through a physical practice, that cannot come through just the purely meditative or mental practice, right? Because the energies need to flow. And don't overestimate your mind, don't underestimate it. The mind all by itself, if it just deals with its realm, is not as powerful and cannot integrate the knowledge into, it cannot manifest it, the knowledge cannot become flesh unless the energies flow through all the realms correctly, okay? Good, I'm gonna leave it at this. Hopefully this was helpful, and I'll talk to you in the next video. Bye-bye.